fantastic leader here. I just want to show you a different angle because the lighting just was not working. Remember, you want to pinch the twist with whatever hand feels comfortable for you and slide it up the line. Stretch, slide, stretch, slide. And that's a pretty small single. That'll probably, a 2-ply would probably be about fingering weight, and 3-ply would be about sport or even light worsted. Working at a yarn shop, learn all these nifty yarn terms. And remember, you don't have to always treadle. You can treadle, build up some twist here between the orifice and your fingers, stop, pull the yarn, a roving, and then pull it out straight so that the twist can travel up it. And then treadle again to feed your newly twisted yarn onto your bobbin. Okay, so you pinch, get it going, treadle, and you just let up on your pinch to let the twist in. This is the inchworm method, and this is the method that I use most often because it produces a much more even single. And your first yarn will be over twisted, so that's just fine. This is a learning experience. We are not aiming for perfection, right? Failure is not defeat unless you stop trying. That's my motto. That's what's gotten me so far in karate too. Failure is not defeat unless you stop trying. I'm a dork, but you already know that. Wow, is it snowing outside? Holy smokes, I'm glad I'm home. Now, what happens if you happen to break the line, huh? Well, that's easy. You just overlap it on the end of your roving and start spinning again. And there you go. You just joined it up. Oh my God, you're amazing. You did it. And if you want a thicker yarn than what I'm doing, because I'm a natural lace spinner apparently, you just let more roving into the line of twist. So this will probably be about what your first yarn will look like. And this is fine. You know what? I want to give you a challenge. I want you to make your first yarn, and no matter how ugly you think it is, I want you to knit something out of it, and I want you to show me. Put a link in the comments where you have made your first yarn and actually made something out of your first yarn. And you could even felt it. I mean, your first wool yarn is the perfect item for felting, because felting erases all sins. That's what my boss at the yarn shop says. She's really funny that way. Alrighty. So hopefully you've got that basics down. Now I'll show you how to work with a factory bot roving. Now when you get your roving, woo, wiggle though. I got caught on the tripod there. It will look like a braid. Most people will sell their hand-dyed rovings like this in a braid. So when you get it, you just want to find the end and start messing with it. Pulling it, yanking it. There's an end in here somewhere. I'm sure of it. So there's not an end there. Well, that was a great example. So we're going to switch down here to the end. All right, I know there's got to be an end down here. Aha! There it is. So then you just want to unbraid this, and you want to break off about a foot or so just to begin with. So that's a good length. Let me undo it just a little bit more here. There we go. And we're just going to grab it firmly and yank it apart, just like that. And that's why you can't spend roving straight from the factory. It's compressed. So we're going to flip it a couple times. That'll help loosen it up a bit. And then we're just going to split it in half. There's usually a seam. See, there's the seam there. So I'm just going to stretch it out a little bit here, just like that. And then I'm going to split it right down the middle. Oh, that was easy. And then we're going to split it in half again. Oh, hey, all right. And we'll probably split it 3 more times here. So there's 1, 2, and 3. Now that's about as small as I can stand to split it. That's pretty small compared to this here. And if you want to spin it just like this, it will produce a pretty darn chunky yarn. So as you're spinning, you want to draft it just a smidgen. Just a smidgen. You want to pre-draft this. I should have said pre-draft. That's what I meant. So we're just going to pre-draft it just a smidgen until the fibers start to slip. There you go. And if you want to do it again, go back down just until they start to slip. It's getting pretty thin now. There we go. Now that's a pretty decent single right there. That'll create a nice worsted yarn. Alrighty, we got that down. Was that super easy or what? Next. I don't know. You tell me what's next. What do you want to learn? Of spinning. Oh, God.